So post mobile devices, things like maybe the iPad?
I have an iPad. This is a US one, which I got my friend to buy me. What do I use it for?
Let me see.
Yep. It's got a picture of my niece and me on there. It's absolutely chock-a-block full of... It is actually a 64 gig, and I think there's about 20 megabytes free on it. I really need to...
What is your initial impression so far? How long have you had it?
I've had it since the day after it came out, whenever that was.
April 3rd.
April 3rd. So I got it April 4th. A guy brought it back from here for me.
Excellent.
And I use it a lot. On the plane over, I flew over to Vegas for NAB, which was like a 10, 11 hour flight. And it didn't even get close to running out on battery. And that's fantastic. You know, even if you go first class, you have crappy screens for watching stuff. So you can put your own videos on there, or not my ones, but you know, download stuff off iTunes, or you know, rip your DVDs, put them on here, and you can watch what you want, and the quality's great, the screen's great. I love the games on it. I'm sure I'm gonna find more productive uses on it, but even just in a couple of times where I've shown clients some of my work, I did that at NAB and said, have you seen this? And so I'd show them one of the videos, you go into the videos, and you play something, and they go, wow, that looks amazing, because it is a, it's almost an HD screen, and it looks, you know, you can't really tell here, but it looks really good,
sure.
And it's impressive, and it's just a really nice presentation tool.
Does lack of flash implement or impede your use or in full enjoyment of the experience?
Only in that, you know, obviously, most of my videos embedded as flash on my website and is on most people's websites. So that is slightly frustrating. Full flash websites are quite rare these days, and not something I like anyway. So it's not a huge issue, but I don't understand the lack of support of flash. It seems a bit strange to me. I'd like them to do that. They won't do it.
At least Vimeo works.
Vimeo does work, but not the embeds yet. They are going to have that very
exposure
soon.
Exposure room?
I don't think I can mention that while we're here.
Can I? But
exposure room, you do support iPad and iPhone video embeds. Vimeo will be supporting it very soon.
Wonderful.
But the Vimeo site is iPhone friendly and works very well.
So since this is a mobile divide, maybe a few years from now,
yeah.
Mobile technology, whether it's a BlackBerry or an iPhone or an iPad, et cetera, where do you see it playing a role in your life that isn't now in terms of either work or play or just
at the moment,
family, friends?
At the moment, the BlackBerry and mobile communication, mobile email in particular, is essential for me because I get like 2,000-3,000 emails a day. And a lot of them, I don't need to, they're just notifications or something or other, but a lot of them are questions. Now, if I didn't have the ability to sit in a taxi and reply to emails, or at a break, reply to emails, I would then have to deal with them all when I get home. Having instant communication and being able to cope with my workload throughout the day is essential to me. Wouldn't it be great in an ideal world I'd have one device that does it all for me? I don't think it's ever going to happen because keyboards are disappearing, and you know, as much as I like the iPhone, I still struggle typing with it. You know, mm-hmm. It's never going to be as fast as a proper keyboard.
Mm-hmm.
I'd love to have a device that had a switchable SIM, or maybe phone companies stop being so greedy. That would be nice. So when you travel, you can just have one number, and you're not charged 20, 30 pounds or dollars, whatever it is, a megabyte, because there's no reason for it. In the future, that's what I'd like. I'd like to see the mobile phone companies stop ripping us all off, because you know, I've been with friends and they've been over in London, and they said, oh, we can't touch the iPhone data. We have to turn it off because it's $56 a megabyte. $56? I mean, some web pages are about 300-400k, and you can imagine how easy
sure,
that can build
definitely.
Up. Especially with you check your email and there's some pictures in there. This stuff, and somebody sends you an attachment and you don't realize just how big it is, you've just spent $100 downloading that really stupid picture
sure.
they sent you.
Sure.
So yeah, I mean, hopefully things will get better for us all. Technology is great. I am carrying numerous devices around with me. So currently I walk around the States with three phones and my UK iPhone switched off in the hotel room.
Thank you so much for your time and being here today at Mobile Divide.
You're welcome. Thanks. Pleasure. So,
and for our audience, what's the best way to learn more about you, contact you, et cetera, or follow you maybe on Twitter? Or
yeah, my Twitter name is at Philip Bloom. My website is Philip Bloom, philipblom.co.uk. I'm hoping there's going to be a little caption along here. Can you do that?
I think we can make that happen.
Motion graphics and things like that.
I'll have to talk to someone.
Maybe get in touch with ILM or something.
Exactly.
Yeah.
That's a good point.
I think you should.
Thanks again. And also a special thanks to Vimeo for allowing us to film here today. Very, very, very happy to be here. Again, this is Mobile Divide, and we'll see you next time.